right now, and we're gonna show you how to get the rats the hell out of a house. And by the way, I'm gonna teach you in a moment how to prevent rats from going over there, or what never, ever, ever to do in a rat-infested house. But before I do that, I'm gonna show you this here real quick. So look down here, right here we have crushed granite. So this is a crushed granite driveway. Now this entire driveway, if you look down there, you have this entire driveway. This driveway, as we pan back and forth, and just look at this driveway here. This driveway, the concrete was all busted up, it was all on top of each other. And so if you were gonna go and bust this driveway out and lay a new driveway and replace the driveway, it would cost you literally about $10,000 to go and replace this particular driveway right here. So here's a tip to go save you a lot of money. If you're in a little bit lower income area, if you're in an area that you don't have to put a brand new driveway in, but you need some sort of driveway coming up, what you do is you tear out the old busted up driveway, literally, if the concrete's falling on top of each other, you tear up the old driveway, and here's what you do. This is literally gonna save you $8,000 to $10,000 on a new driveway. You go and you put in, you bring in what's called crushed granite. You have to bring in several yards of crushed granite. They bring in this granite and they roll it out, and as they spread it out, they bring in one of those big rollers, and you can just rent one of those rollers for literally $350, and you roll it, and that crushed granite, the more you roll it, the more it compacts. And look down here, look at this, this is actually pretty cool. So the more it compacts, and it creates ground that will not go and wash away with rain, it will not go and blow away with the wind, and even though it's loose underneath that crushed granite, what happens is it's compacted down, and you'll save anywhere from $8,000 to $10,000 on a brand new driveway. Now, I would not use this in middle income homes or higher income homes, but middle to lower income, lower middle income to lower income homes, you can put in these crushed granite driveways and save a ton of money. By the way, if you guys wanna go see a rat infestation, bam, we'll give us a little double tap, we'll give us a little like right there, okay? And just put show us in the chat line. Literally go put show us in the chat line, do a little double tap right there and go put show us in the chat line. So let's go walk through here. Let's go check out this rat infestation. Now, you can see this house has been, big freaking wasp right there. You can see this house has been remodeled and redone. So it's a house that we're gonna go and set up to go rent and rent for a landlord. But when you walk in the house, the house stinks because it has a major rat infestation. We're about to show you what's going on over here. So look, here's some of the rat traps over here. Oh, watch out, Zach. All right, so here's some of the rat traps that we literally have here. But if you look down here, right over here, that, can you get in there? That in there is all the rat poo. That right there is all the rat poo that's in this area. All that's rat poo. Just look, may I just use that? Just get right down in there, Zach. Just jump down there, right there in the rat poo. All right, all that's the rat poo just going on right down in there, right there, okay? So all that is the rat poo that's going on. Now, and then, so we've gone and we begin to set traps. Now here's what the rats have actually done. Now you have to understand, rats, they've survived millions and millions and millions of years. They survive on, they can survive through floods, they can survive through freezing, because rats literally can jump up to 4 feet high. That would be the same as you and I jumping close to 80 feet high. I mean, talk about having some freaking hops. They can jump 4 feet high, it'd be like us jumping 80 feet. They can also, a rat can fit through something the size of a quarter, okay? Fit through, you know what that's like, Zach? No, okay. A rat can literally fit through something like the size of a quarter. It can squeeze its entire fat little rat body through something the size of a quarter. And they can also go, they can eat through metal, they can eat through concrete, so wire mesh won't keep them out. So, what do rats need? Three things to survive. Oxygen, food, and water. Oxygen, food, water, obviously to survive, right? Plus they like to do it a lot, right? So, listen, we could solve the whole problem if they gave us little rat condoms. If they just give us little rats, little fucking rat condoms, we'd save all the issues in the world. But they don't have rat condoms. Zach, what do you think that would be like to go and be able to, would you be willing to save planet, Zach? To save this world, would you be willing to go and help slip those condoms on those little rats, little rat condoms?
I think we just have to teach them to do it themselves.
Yeah, yeah, okay, educating the rats.
Educate first.
Educating the rats, all right? So, people say, no kidding, bad credit, low income, want to do this, all right? So, if you want, by the way, people are putting some cool, funny comments, okay? So, check this out. People are putting good comments. Watch this. Put a mask on. Boy, I would love to learn. So, Heather, you want to learn? So, Heather, if you want to learn this right now, I'll give you a... Let's just start you slow. If you go to millionsinforeclosures.com, go to millionsinforeclosures.com, Heather, and I'll give you a book right now. It's a discounted book. It's like $29. But usually the book's like something like $97. But if you go to Millions of Foreclosures, show you about how to get your first foreclosure. But look down here. All right, so here we are. Here's what the rats do. Oh, here's one thing you never, ever, ever want to do. I'm gonna show you. We're gonna look and see if we found some damn rats. Here's one thing you never, ever wanna do. Don't ever go put poison on the walls. Because what happens is, so if they go and set poison in the walls of a rat infested house, what happens is those poison actually makes the rats dehydrate. So if they go put poison, actually they won't put in the walls, they'll put poison. So right around here, they'll come and they'll set poison traps. Well, if they're not the traps that the rats get caught in, the rats will go over there and start immediately looking for a water source. So then the rats will go up into the drywall, they'll crawl inside the walls, and what will happen is they will chew through your copper piping looking for water. That's what's happened over here. So look over here. So the rats actually began chewing through the piping. So they'll chew through this copper piping. And I'm gonna show you the other side where they went through the actual rat source. But here's what happened, look down here. So what the best way to go use is you go, boom, look at that, all right? So you go over there and you put some peanut butter in there. You put some peanut butter, and they set these traps, so they're literally putting peanut butter on the traps, okay? Think you're fast enough to put your finger into that?
No.
Think you want to try it? Let's see if you're fast enough, okay? Let's see how fast you are.
Oh, boy.
Let's see. You want to try it? They what's that show they used to do that stuff on? Where they remember they put a shark hook in their mouth and they jump in the water? What was it? MTV. You know what MTV is? Fear Factor.
One of those shows.
Okay. So let's look at this, right? So here comes the rats. What you do is people always say you use cheese, but you use peanut butter because these fucking rats are smart. People have been putting cheese for 100 years. The rats can go steal the cheese. You put peanut butter there, so the rats can't go and steal the peanut butter. They start licking them, and look, here's what happens. The rats come, right? Boom! And then guess what? Now, sometimes it's sad because they lose the little rat legs, and you gotta put them in like a little rat wheelchair and stuff, and it's kind of sad. But let's go see if we can find some rats, because the rats were looking for a major water source in this house. And the reason is because there was originally, in this water source, originally there was poison put in this house, I believe. And so they went to go look for the water source. So what you want to use is you want to use these suckers, okay? So these are the things you want to use. You want to use rat traps, and you can go set them yourself. I prefer to have a professional. So we call it professional out there. But there's a company, it's a nationwide company we use. We use them on a TV show for this house. They're called Truly Nolan. They're great, they're inexpensive, they're professionals. They'll go set them and they'll put, They'll see if you look real close, they use a sticky substance right there. They'll use peanut butter or some other sort of sticky substance. And what will happen is rats can't steal it, and they'll actually go and clear all the rats out of the house for you. Now, the rats, we cut this drywall out so we can show you. So we're gonna come here, we're gonna get all the rat poo out, the rat infestation. But by the way, people ask any good questions over there? Any good questions, Zach? Zach, let me tell you, let me look at the questions. What's that? You think we're gonna find a rat, Zach?
Peanut butter.
Huh?
I think so.
You think we're gonna find some?
There's enough poop.
There's enough poop, think we're gonna find a rat, all right? All right, so let's just check this out right now. Let's see, saw with the rat house 3 months ago, disgusting. By the way, if you like this, go give us a quick little double tap. Go give us a little, let's put a comment on there, all right? So, let's follow this one. Let's literally put, show us the rat. My social media hate team hates when I do this. They're like, if you put show us the rat, then people are like, well, that's not positive. And people are gonna think, like, they're calling you a rat. No, these. We're just put on there and put, show us the rats. Let's see if we can find a rat. And literally, I gotta open this door. It's fucking stinky in here, okay? All right, so it smells pretty damn bad. We gotta let some air in here. So on the other side of this wall right over here, on the other side of this wall is where that opening was. So let's go and let's see if we can find a rat right here. Ooh, there's another rat trap. Ooh, I gotta go set that rat trap off. Watch this. There's another rat trap right here. Ready? Let's go see. Bam! Look at that. Just lose your little rat hand. And look, let's look back here. Let's look, see if we can find any rats. Maybe a rat might come running out of here. Literally, Zach, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna scream if a rat comes running out of here?
I might. I was thinking about it.
You might think you might scream? Alright, let's see. I've literally had rats avoid the food and come running out at me right now. Okay? All right, so watch this. Give us a little quick little double tap. Oh, by the way, real quick, go share this. Go share this with your friends, okay? Just go share it. Your friends want to see this stuff. They love this kind of stuff. Listen, rather than watching a whole setup, on TV that you don't know if it's real or not. You're actually gonna see it real right here, right now. Watch this cool stuff. Oh my God. There is a decimated rat. That's a big motherfucker too. Look at that. Get in there, Zach. Get in there, get dirty in there. Look at that. Oh, look at here. Look, you see a little rat head? Get in there. Little rat head. There's a little rat head right there. You got caught right underneath. That's a big damn rat. There's the fur. He's a little deflated sole right in there. But they're literally right there.
That's it. Look at that. Bring him in.
Literally. A little rat head. That can't be clean. Okay? Little rat head and his little rat body. Just look at this. Oh. What do you think? Look at this. Oh. This is not good for that rat. Okay, let's go, excuse me here. So, we're at little rat head.
Nice.
Look, you can see his little rat teeth. Look, he's got little buck teeth. He needed braces, look at him. Look at that guy, he needed braces. Do you see his little teeth?
Well, it stinks.
Yeah, well, yes, Zach, it's gonna stink. Do you see his little teeth?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Kind of smiling.
This guy picked the fuck up a time to take a nap, all right? So here it is. Zach, would you like, look, so, but here's, here, let me tell you, this is the most screwed up thing, and this really pisses me off. And I can't believe this. And this is gonna piss the PETA people off. I can't believe somebody would go and skin a rat just to make a rat coat out of it. That is fucking sad, isn't it? Like, that is so sad. They would just, rat, what do you think about that? Somebody would go skin that rat just to make a rat coat out of it.
It takes a lot of rats.
It would take a lot of rats to make a rat coat, Zach. Look at that. Bam. Oh, by the way, you guys like that? Put money in the chat line. This is how you make money. Put money in the chat line if you like that. All right, we're throwing this around here because I don't want to sleep in the house anymore. All right, so. All right, gonna have to go and wash my hands. Okay, so here we are, and you got rats. So now, what happened is the back of this dishwasher line, so you have water that comes in here. You have clean water and dirty water that comes out here. And what's happening is the rats, we set a trap behind the water line. And the reason why we set a trap behind this dishwasher is because they're gonna come in here to grab water, the water source. So look where we're setting our rat traps, okay? Here's where the rat traps are set. One behind the water heater, or excuse me, one behind the dishwasher. So you got one behind the dishwasher, you have one under the sink, because they're going for the water sources. And then we have another one over here. There's a bathtub right here, look back here. You have the bathtub right here. And then you have the water lines coming right here. So what's happened is we've set rat traps close to all the water sources of this house. And bam, 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 cleared rats out. So you actually saw one rat that we've cleared out. We have to get some out here to reset the traps. Matt, can you make sure somebody resets the traps? Okay. Show Matt something. I'm probably talking to myself. There's Matt, okay? All right, so let me advise people this thing. I have imaginary friends, which I do. But it's hot as hell in here. By the way, see if anybody, let me see if anybody has any questions, all right? Zach, you want to answer any questions for anybody?
I don't know what
they
got. Throw them at me.
Sean says, I just shared your video and let others know that you appreciate it. Love it. That's right. There's a fridge, a waterline fridge too, right? Time to eat. People are saying it's time to eat. They do their job. Bad smell, all right? By the way, if you guys like that, just go give a little double tap right there. There you go. Give them a little double tap, all right? So this is the way. Oh, let me see this here. Yeah, people are cranking up. So here's the thing, when you're flipping houses, a lot of times people get really scared of like rats or things that could go wrong, but on your flip, every single problem in flip, there is a solution. Here's the great thing. So you can have mold in houses. Well, how do you get rid of mold? You get rid of the oxygen, you get rid of the water, you get rid of the mold. How do you get rid of rats? You get rid of the water sources. Well, you can't take water out of a house, so then you plant the rat traps near the water sources. How do you go and find out where the water is, where the water leaks are? Well, you follow, if the water leaks are up high, then the leaks are coming from a roof. If the leaks are about right here, then they're coming from the top of the windows. So you have to seal on the outside of the top of the windows. And if you have leaks down here, or if you have leaks at the baseboard, you either have leaks coming in from the bottom of the window, or if you have leaks down here, it literally could be as simple as something as the ground is higher than the actual concrete. So one time I went to go purchase this house and it literally had mold all the way around it, this height up. Mold all the way around it. And nobody wanted to go and purchase that property. So I went and I purchased this property. And the only problem was the concrete on the outside, the dirt came up higher than concrete. So literally what happens is the water absorbs in the wall from the dirt. And all we had to do was excavate the land around it. There was no drainage problems. Excavate it below the concrete and we fixed the water and thus we fixed the mold problem. But I got the house for like $30,000 cheaper than anybody else will even want to buy the house because no one knew how to fix the simple problem. So you have to go and know how to fix these simple problems. And in real estate, it's so cool because it's based upon sixth grade math. These are simple problems that you can go and fix. So how do you go and fix a fire damage house? So that's a little bit further. That one's a little bit farther down the line than most of you guys. But fire damage houses are huge fixes for these houses. So never be afraid of like learning how to flip houses. Never be afraid of going out there and taking a house. That might be a big challenge, especially if you guys are part of the Wolfpack. You can call into us mentors and we'll into the mentor line and we'll help you guys out. But I love it. I love going and finding this disgustingness. I love finding this dirtiness because this is the kind of stuff that can make you a lot of money. That little rat, to be honest with you. I gotta tell you something, okay? That's a $30,000 rat. Would you take that rat out for $30,000? Because I bought this house for 30 grand. I put $30,000 in repairs and I'm selling the sucker for $105,000. That's a $30,000 rat, all right? Everyone put 30K in the chat line real quick. Put 30K in the chat line. Guys, thanks for watching this. And if you wanna see more of this stuff, go to Armando Flips on Snapchat. Go to Armando Flips on Snapchat. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.